The 2015 Paris Climate Agreement was a moment of optimism. The world had rallied around a common cause, lowering emissions of greenhouse gases, attempting to limit global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius. 6 years on, climate change is now a climate crisis. The efforts made so far have not been enough.
Net zero by 2050, blah, 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 net zero, blah, 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 climate neutral, blah, blah, blah.
And it's not only Greta Thunberg that thinks so. This map shows the effectiveness of actions taken by 36 countries to try and keep the 1.5 goal alive. Only the Gambia, a tiny nation in West Africa, is doing enough to help meet the target. The biggest driver of global warming are carbon dioxide emissions, and the biggest cause of these emissions is the burning of fossil fuels. We have known this for years, and yet, from 2009 to 2019, the world's consumption of these fuels barely changed. So why are our energy consumption habits so slow to change? Electricity production is a key issue. In 2018, it was responsible for 40% of the world's total CO2 emissions. Coal-fired power plants produce a third of the world's electricity. Finding ways to retire these plants and produce cleaner power is a top priority, but where to begin? 80% of new coal power stations planned worldwide are in Asia, where electricity needs are growing. Two of the region's biggest economies, India and China, are both highly dependent on coal for their electricity. China has committed to stop funding coal-fired plants abroad, but more than 360 of them are currently under construction in China itself. And electricity shortages in early November pushed Chinese authorities to ramp up coal production by more than 1 million tonnes. Even though renewable energy sources are now cheaper in many cases, they are not trusted to deliver the power needed in a market where coal is synonymous with energy security. Many also fear catastrophic knock-on effects if coal-fired plants were to cease production, including mass unemployment in the plants and in related sectors. But things have improved. As the costs associated with wind and solar power have decreased, these sources have become more widespread. Renewable energies now constitute the world's second biggest source of electricity. In 2019, more than a quarter of electricity was produced from renewable energy sources. They are now more used than gas and nuclear power, but still lag behind coal, the most polluting energy source. One of the major stumbling blocks in the energy transition is funding. According to the International Energy Agency, to achieve net zero by 2050, annual investment in clean energy worldwide will need to reach $4 trillion by 2030. That's more than triple the current level. Many countries have committed to becoming carbon neutral in the coming decades. China and Russia have set 2060 as the goal. India is aiming for 2070. But just as important as countries are companies. What action are they taking? In the car industry, a widespread switch to electric vehicles is underway. Leading names like Volvo and Jaguar have committed to going 100% electric in the coming decades. But for now, roads remain crowded with polluting cars. Consumers still opt for gas-guzzling SUVs, accounting for 42% of total car sales in 2020. Airlines around the world have also pledged to aim for net zero emissions. The International Air Transport Association has set 2050 as the deadline. But this net zero goal is tough to square with projected passenger numbers, which are set to double over the same timeline. Airlines are placing their hopes in the development of sustainable aviation fuels derived from organic products like cooking oil and algae. But these fuels are four times more expensive than kerosene. In 2019, they accounted for less than 0.1% of the fuel used in aviation. Researchers say it will not be possible to keep global warming below 2 degrees without a drastic reduction in air traffic. One option to force companies to reduce their emissions is carbon pricing. It can take the form of a tax on pollution, or a requirement to buy emissions permits, which can be traded. The problem is in the pricing. A ton of carbon should cost between $40 and $80 to effectively dissuade companies from using fossil fuels. But worldwide, the price per ton of carbon is under $10 for the vast majority of emissions under pricing schemes. The European Union has been a pioneer in this field and wants to extend the scheme to the construction and road transport sectors. But the knock-on effect is an increase in the cost of living for consumers, with increased likelihood of social unrest. 2020 saw a dramatic drop in CO2 emissions, but as the world reopens after COVID-19, they are now projected to reach a record high in 2023. The COP26 climate summit in Glasgow saw a range of pledges from various countries, from phasing out coal-fired power to ending the financing of new fossil fuel projects overseas. The question now is whether these promises can be delivered on. Developed nations have so far failed to make good on plans to raise $100 billion a year by 2020 to help developing nations make the energy transition, a pledge that was first made in 2009.